I'm writing a book on retrieval, augmented generation with Wiley Publications. And an inescapable part about writing a book on RAG is the fact that I need to use a vector database. What the f*** is a vector database? You're probably familiar with traditional databases like a relational database. They store data in tables where each row represents a record, and then each column is going to represent some type of data, which could be name, age, address, stuff like that. Searching and querying these type of databases is pretty straightforward because you can use SQL to retrieve records based on whatever specified criteria. For example, what you see here on the screen. But what if you need to store and query data that can't be easily represented as rows and columns? What if your data is more complex, like images, videos, audio files, or even abstract concepts like user preferences or semantic meaning? Imagine trying to find all the images that look like a specific pair of shoes in a traditional database. Or imagine trying to search with the sound of an object and retrieve back all images or videos that contain the object that makes that sound. It's going to be nearly impossible, just untenable. But what if there was a way to represent complex, unstructured data in a format that captures its inherent relationships and allows for efficient similarity-based searching? This is where vectors come to the rescue. If the term sounds mathematical, that's because it is. A vector is a mathematical object with both magnitude and direction. In our context, it's going to represent some type of data in a high-dimensional space. Vectors allow you to represent data. Text documents can be represented as vectors. Audio clips can be transformed into vectors based on the different audio features of that clip. You could take an image and convert that into a vector. That will allow you to do some interesting type of clustering so you can find these semantically similar objects in this high-dimensional space. Vectors representing similar objects or concepts will be closer to each other in this multidimensional space. Why can't you use a regular database? Traditional databases are great, but they're not optimized for searching, filtering, or ranking based on complex, high-dimensional relationships. For example, suppose you wanted to find all songs in your music database that have a similar vibe to the song that's playing right now. This is where vector databases comes in. What the f*** is a vector database exactly? Vector database is a database that's specifically designed to store, manage, query, and perform operations on large collections of vectors. They use specialized indexing and search algorithms like approximate nearest neighbor search for fast and accurate searching, filtering, and ranking of vectors. What's the role of vector databases in retrieval augmented generation? In a typical RAG workflow, the external data that we're using to augment the LLM's knowledge is first converted into vector embeddings. The vector embeddings are then stored in a vector database. Then when a user submits a query, the RAG system is going to follow these steps. The query is going to be converted into a vector embedding using the same embedding models that we use to embed our documents. We're going to take that vector and we're going to search our vector database to find data points that are most similar to that query vector. The retrieved data is then going to be used to augment the original query prompt. And then finally, the augmented prompt is fed to the language model to generate a response. We'll discuss how this works in depth as we progress along in this series, but for now, I want to discuss choosing a vector database. No doubt the market for vector databases is exploding. There's numerous options out there that you can use. And so the hard part is now choosing which one you want to use for your project, or in my case, which one to include in a book that's going to have my name attached to it forever. And after much thinking, I decided to use Qdrant for my book and for my LinkedIn Learning course. There's a number of reasons why I chose Qdrant. One was the people I respect the most, my mentors, they all recommend Qdrant. But some of the technical reasons is because of its really impressive performance, flexibility, and developer-friendly ecosystem. Qdrant outperforms other vector databases in terms of both indexing and querying speed. It can handle billion-scale vector collections without even breaking a sweat, which makes it perfect for large-scale enterprise RAG applications. In addition to storing vectors, you can attach arbitrary metadata to each vector, which is incredibly useful for RAG because this will enable the storage and querying of additional context alongside those vector embeddings. It's also easy to integrate and deploy. It's just a delight to work with. It has well-documented API, well-documented client libraries. It just makes it really easy to integrate into existing parts of the stack. Deployment is also straightforward. Qdrant has a managed cloud service and an easy-to-use Docker deployment if you want to host it locally and by yourself. The flexibility just allows for getting up and running quickly without needing a lot of infrastructure to get set up. Qdrant has built up a vibrant community and ecosystem around it, so the development team is active, they're responsive, the documentation is well done, comprehensive. There's a lot of examples and tutorials that'll get you started on their website and also just spread out through the internet. There's also a Discord community, which is a great place to get help and share knowledge with other Qdrant users as well. And of course, it's Apache 2.0 license. It's an open source project. It's free to use and deploy self-hosted, and also has a generous free tier. I'm excited to use Qdrant in my book, my LinkedIn Learning course, and throughout this series of videos with you. We'll learn to do some interesting, complex stuff using Qdrant. It'll be fun, interesting series. Make sure you're subscribing to the channel. Make sure you got the bell notifications hit so that you can be notified when the next video comes out. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.